Sutra, with respect to all worlds, he does not discriminate. Regarding all dharmas, he is without false thinking. Although he contemplates all dharmas, he does not grasp at them. He always rescues living beings, yet none are crossed over. All worlds are only thoughts. Within each of them are all kinds of differences. He knows that the state of thoughts is dangerous and deep, and manifests spiritual penetrations to rescue beings. Just like the free and easy power of a magician, so too are the Bodhisattva's spiritual transformations. His body pervades the Dharma realm and space. According with the minds of living beings, none do not see him. He is apart from the differentiations of subject and object, and there is no grasping at defilement or purity. Whether bound up or liberated, his wisdom is totally forgotten. He only wishes to bestow happiness on living beings everywhere. All worlds are only the force of thoughts. With wisdom, he enters them with a fearless heart. He considers all dharmas in the same way, investigating throughout the three births of time. There is nothing which can be obtained. Commentary. With respect to all worlds, he does not discriminate. When the Bodhisattva teaches and transforms living beings in the world, he uses wisdom light to clearly understand all living beings' basic natures. Yet he does not discriminate between good and bad. Regarding all dharmas, he is without false thinking. He is equal towards all dharmas and does not give rise to false thinking and say, I should use this particular dharma and transform that particular living being. He doesn't produce this kind of false thinking. Although he contemplates all dharmas, he does not grasp at them. Although he uses wisdom to contemplate all dharmas, yet he doesn't grasp or become attached to any of them. He always rescues living beings, yet none are crossed over. He constantly rescues and crosses over living beings, but he doesn't grasp at the thought of crossing over living beings. He doesn't say, do you know, I now teach and transform living beings. I now am doing this good thing for living beings. I am cultivating the Bodhisattva path. He doesn't have this kind of consideration. Every day he crosses over living beings, yet there are none which are crossed over. Every day he is teaching and transforming living beings, yet every day there are no living beings that are crossed over. This is also like what is said in the training school, every day eating rice, yet not a single grain is eaten. Every day wearing clothes, yet not a single thread is worn. Why does it say this? This is just describing the state of one who is without attachment. All worlds are only thoughts. All worlds come into being from thoughts. Living beings' false thoughts create illusory worlds. Within each of them are all kinds of differences. In the world, there are all kinds of false thinking. Each living being has his own different kind of false thinking. He knows that the state of thoughts is dangerous and deep. He knows that the state of false thinking is extremely dangerous and very difficult to understand. We cultivate the way in order to cut off false thinking. Fasting is just for the purpose of striking down one's false thinking, to beat it to death. So I've asked those who are fasting, have you died yet? I'm not asking whether your false thinking has died. I'm also asking if you still have your greedy mind, a mind which thinks about how you haven't eaten or how many days have gone by since you haven't eaten. If you have those considerations, then you have false thinking and you haven't stopped your heart of greed yet. You want to stop your greedy mind. Although you like to eat and drink good things, you are not getting anything to eat or drink. You are battling with your false thinking. This is the purpose of those who cultivate the way, to stop false thinking. If you wish to touch money, that is false thinking. If you wish to take advantage of situations, that is false thinking. The Bodhisattva knows that false thinking is dangerous, and so he manifests spiritual penetrations to rescue beings. Living beings revolve in the dangerous paths. The Bodhisattva manifests all kinds of spiritual penetrations in order to cross over and liberate living beings. But these spiritual penetrations are by no means real. What are they like then? Just like the free and easy power of a magician. This is like a magician possessed of the free and easy power of transforming something into nothing and nothing into something. He can make things suddenly become big and suddenly become small. Just as the magician's powers are unknowable and endless, so too are the Bodhisattva's spiritual transformations. The transformations from the Bodhisattva's spiritual penetrations are like those conjured by a magician. His body pervades the Dharma realm and space. His single body totally fills up all of the Dharma realm and the realm of space, according with the minds of living beings. None do not see him. He accords with the minds of beings so that none do not see his form. He is apart from the differentiations of subject and object. He does not discriminate between subject and object because both of these discriminations are non-existent. They are both separated from, and there is no grasping or defilement or purity within the heart of the Bodhisattva. There isn't any defilement or purity. So it is said in the Heart Sutra, not defiled and not pure, which means having no dwelling place. One can't be attached to defilement or purity. Whether bound up or liberated, his wisdom is totally forgotten. Perhaps living beings are bound by karma, or maybe they have attained liberation. Regardless of whether they are one way or the other, this kind of wisdom is non-existent. It is forgotten. The kind of wisdom which is connected with being bound or liberated is totally forgotten. He only wishes to bestow happiness on living beings everywhere. The Bodhisattva wants to benefit all living beings. Because living beings wish to strive for benefit, they fight. Why are there wars in the world? Because groups of people strive for benefit. People who are stupid are treated by those who are intelligent. And those intelligent people not only treat others, they also treat themselves. The wars in the world arise because of this. So the Bodhisattva wishes to transfer his advantages to all beings. He doesn't want them for himself. He just wants you to obtain some advantage, which is whatever you happen to like. He has forgotten himself for the sake of others. He doesn't have a self. This is the Bodhisattva's motivating principle. So no one fights with the Bodhisattva. Even the demon kings are happy when they see him, and they don't fight with him. All worlds are only the force of thoughts. All worlds come into being by means of the force of false thinking. False thinking has brought about the illusory worlds. With wisdom, he enters them with a fearless heart. He uses wisdom to understand that all worlds are false, and so he is fearless. He is able to see through them and put them down. He considers all dharmas in the same way. He cultivates all kinds of dhyana concentrations and meditations, the dharmas of hearing and considering and various samadhis. He sees they are all equal. Investigating throughout the three periods of time, there is nothing which can be obtained. The past, present, and future are not obtainable. This also means that past, present, and future thoughts are not obtainable. Why? Because the past has already gone by. You say this is the past, well, that's already past. You say this is the present, well, the present doesn't stop, and the future hasn't yet to come. In searching for the three periods of time, nothing can be obtained. Everything is without a substance. It does not matter how you seek, there is nothing that can be found. Nothing is obtainable and nothing is real. Sutra, he is able to enter the past and exhaust the boundary of before. He is able to enter the future and exhaust the boundary of afterwards. He is able to enter all places in the present, constantly and diligently observing them as being non-existent. He goes along with the still extinct Dharma of Nirvana, dwelling without striving and without any reliance. His mind, like ultimate reality, is unequaled. He only goes towards Bodhi without ever retreating. He cultivates supreme conduct without turning back in fear. He established in Bodhi and unmoving. The Buddhas and Bodhisattvas in the world exhausted the Dharma realm, so everything is understood. He wishes to obtain the most supreme foremost path and acts as the king of liberation of all wisdom. He must quickly bring forth the Bodhi mind and forever exhaust all outflows and benefit the flocks of beings. He tends towards Bodhi with the mind of purity. His merit and virtue is expansive, great and ineffable, which in order to benefit living beings, he names and describes in detail. All of you worthy ones should well listen to him. Commentary: the Bodhisattva who first brings forth the Bodhi mind meditates on all dharmas and discovers that in the end, the three borders of time are unobtainable. He is able to enter the past and exhaust the boundary of before. The boundary of before is non-existent. He is able to enter the future and exhaust the boundary of afterwards. Although the future hasn't come yet, still he is able to enter it, so the boundary of afterwards is also non-existent. He is able to enter all places in the present. He is able to enter all the worlds and places of the present, constantly and diligently observing them as being non-existent. All the places in the present are also not real. Thus, he always diligently regards all dharmas as being totally unobtainable. He goes along with the still extinct dharma of Nirvana. Why are all dharmas completely unobtainable? Because he goes along with the still extinct dharma of Nirvana, dwelling without striving and without any reliance. This means he abides in the non-striving samadhi. He does not contend with anyone at all, and he also does not rely on any dharma. His mind, like ultimate reality, is unequaled. The mind is just reality, and reality is just the mind. So there is nothing which can be compared to it. He only goes towards Bodhi without ever retreating. He only does towards the Bodhi way, and he never thinks of turning back. His mind is non-retreating. Cultivation is just going forward with vigor and not turning back. He cultivates supreme conduct without turning back in fear. The Bodhisattva cultivated all the superior doors of practice without fearing any suffering and difficulty. He is established in Bodhi and unmoving. He is always secured and unmoving in the Bodhi way. One who leaves home to cultivate the way should always have a very solid mind for the way. One can't have a retreating mind when being tested by any state of experience. The Buddhas and Bodhisattvas in the world, the Buddhas and of all the Bodhisattvas within all worlds, exhaust the Dharma realm, so everything is understood. All the principles in the Dharma realm are understood by the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. He wishes to obtain the most supreme foremost path. The Bodhisattva cultivates in order to achieve the unsurpassed right and equal enlightenment and acts as the king of liberation of all wisdom. Therefore, he is able to obtain all wisdom and the liberation within liberation. He must quickly bring forth the Bodhi mind. How does one attain the foremost path of the King of Liberation. By quickly bringing forth the Buddha mind and forever exhaust all outflows and benefit the flux of beings. One forever cuts off all of the one's bad habits, false ignorance and afflictions. Ignorance or heart of desire. The desire mind is the greatest outflow of human beings. Whoever has a desire mind has outflows. Whoever doesn't have a heart of desire has forever expelled outflows. The desire mind refers particularly to sexual desire. If your thoughts of sexual desire move you, you have outflows. You outflow into the triple realm and undergo birth and death. If you have no outflows, you can forever benefit the flux of beings. Then one can enable living beings to obtain some advantage. He tends towards body with a mind of purity. If you always go towards the body path, your mind is pure. His merit and virtue is expansive, great and ineffable. If you are able to bring forth the body mind, then the kind of the merit and virtue you will reap will be the most vast and ineffable. This is the kind of merit and virtue which, in order to benefit living beings, the names and describes in detail the merit and virtue from first bringing forth the body mind is ineffable. So why does one still wish to speak about it? Because one wishes to cause all living beings to similarly bring forth the body mind and in the same way achieve the unsurpassed path. So within what cannot be spoken of, one speaks of this kind of merit and virtue. All of you worthy ones should well listen to him. All of you good people who have entered the flow of the sages should listen well to the principles that the Bodhisattva explains.